I just want to say, this is a, I'm glad I'm not a
judge
in this particular non-existent
context. Hot
it would
dog.
Be very,
hot dog.
Very difficult. I think we could have a tie, right? You could have a tie, technically. Yeah. Unless, can't have a tie if seven people vote. Yeah, but people could vote for the option that it's a tie. Oh. Okay, so Ty could win. Hey, Chris, is there anything you want to say, talk about, record while I, as quickly as possible, put up a Twitter go ahead and put up a Twitter poll. I'll tell you, I got a Oculus Quest 2 for my wife for Christmas, and everyone said, that's for the family, isn't it? I said, no, it's for my wife, because I know somebody who exercises on it. Well, so now there's a thing, exercises with it. There's this thing that I've been doing called it's a Beat Saber, and you know, where you knock these blocks off, you know, left, right, up, down, and you duck and you move out of the way of walls that come at you. And I was doing Beat Saber last night, and wow, I mean, I really burned some calories, started sweating so much that nobody wanted to put the computer goggle, you know, the Quest 2 on their face, because I said, it helps with your salty sweat. Yeah. Then I found there's a silicone cover you can put on it, so I put that on, and now everybody can just wipe it off. But it's really cool. If you're sweating, though, and you have the silicone cover, does it not slip and slide across your face? No, it's tight. It's grippy? Yeah, grippy. The only problem I have with it is, you know, you have to have a Facebook account, and, you know, Facebook, I was worried about what Facebook knows about me, but yeah. Facebook already knows everything about me, so I got the Oculus, because it's too late.
To preserve your privacy.
Yeah, I've given in. I'm acquiescing like I did in the contest. As we all will and have done. Will do. Right. Wait. Have done and will do.
Have done.
At the end, at the end of the day, I think this is the reason why these are all multi-billion dollar companies. Yeah. Whatever it is they provide is, at the end of the day, worth letting them have all our data. That this is the calculus that most of us end up with.
Yeah, and unless we have some sort of a totalitarian state, then having our data, in my mind, is not that huge of a deal.
I think you're right. I don't want to be the guy at the end of the Twilight Zone episode who was blasé about it, and then the next thing we know, you know, they start rounding people up based on our data. But I do feel in this country anyway that this is mostly at the end of the day. Commerce,
right?
So it's really just about making money.
Sure it is.
And they're not in the business, for example, they're not in the business of using your data to hurt you. They use your data two ways. One is to sell it to third parties,
right, to exploit you.
To exploit you, except to third parties who also have this next part of it, this other way they use data, is true of Facebook and Google and all these places, and of the third parties that they sell it to, and that is to try to show you things you want to see. They're not in the business of showing you ads or populating your feed with things they think you're not interested in.
Well, I agree with that, but the problem is the things that I'm interested in, I've already purchased, and then I keep seeing those ads.
Mm-hmm. Like, so your complaint would be, why don't you, instead of saying, oh, this is what he likes, let's give him more, why don't you use the data to say, this is what he already has, why don't we show him new things,
I would be more
instead of boring him with the same thing that he already has.
Yes, how many times can I look at, 900 different styles of hiking boots or gardening things that I've gotten for my wife. I've got everything I need, so now I need another idea, like maybe something about a bicycle, or maybe I should go camping, or I don't know, an umbrella.
That's murkier, though, on their part, to predict what other things
Too bad. That's their job. If they're going to steal all my, or acquire all of my information, then they need to figure that out.
The thing about it, though, is, and I do remember seeing several studies. Let's say you were looking at hiking boots.
Right.
Now, okay, number one, they don't know necessarily if you bought
anything. They may not know that part. But let's say they know you purchased a pair of hockey boots. Yeah. Consumer behavior studies show that actually most people, and maybe this is not you, but most people are quite open, even if they don't realize it, to getting another pair of hiking boots. Okay. So when you buy a pair of hiking boots, actually from a consumer manipulation standpoint, it makes a lot of sense to keep showing you other hiking boots. You may not have my problem, which is being a collector.
No.
I go on Jags, where, like, I'll tell you different areas. Okay, I went through, do you remember when cigars became a big deal for a while?
Yeah, cigar culture.
I got caught up in it.
Yeah,
me too. So the next thing you know, I've got 8 humidors. Because you see a humidor, and then all of a sudden your mind is like, ooh, are there other cool humidors? And the next thing you know, you have a collection of humidors for no reason. The same thing happened with inexpensive, thank God, novelty watches. Oh, that's a fun watch. It's Looney Tunes characters on a dial that rotates. It makes it look like they're in a washing machine going around and around.
I would like to have that because I collect watches.
Yeah, okay, and these are not, you know, these are not even $100 watches in most cases.
Uh-huh.
The next thing you know, 30 watches.
That's right.
I went through a pocket knife phase. I've got 10 or 12 pocket knives. Not because I'm so specifically into pocket knives, but I have this habit of serial acquisition of things.
Well, that's really interesting.
That's why I have, I shouldn't even say this.
Go ahead.
Because I'm not a gun nut or a gun guy. I'm not a member of the NRA. I am not hostile towards most gun control laws and stuff.
Right.
But I do have like 15 guns.
Oh, God.
Because what happens is you go, I want a gun. Huh? And, and then you go, I bought an HK. Well, I should have a SIG, too.
I think everybody should.
Lighters. You know, lighters?
Lighters, yeah.
Lighters. Mm-hmm. I got a ton of lighters.
Zippo.
Sunglasses.
Mm-hmm.
I got all kinds of different pair of non-prescription sunglasses for no reason.
Where do you keep all this
stuff? It's stupid. Well, I have a whole bunch of those drawer units on casters.
Mm-hmm.
And the drawers are just, you know, there's a lighter drawer and a sunglass drawer.
Oh, that's awesome.
And I guess my point being, this is the kind of, my kind of mentality makes me very susceptible to, I bought a thing pragmatically to you, let's go to hiking boots.
Right.
I actually have 2 pairs of hiking boots.
Awesome.
And if I saw an ad for a new pair of hiking boots and there was anything about it that I could justify why adding it to my collection is not entirely duplicative, I'll buy them.
Yeah.
And it's not that I'm rich. I'm not rich. And I'm not buying, I don't collect like uber expensive items. It's not, I don't have Fabergé eggs or a collectible Beanie Baby. It's not that.
Right.
So there you go.
Well, have you been collecting this stuff since you were a kid?
Well, became an adult and was earning, you know, my own money. But I go through, the point is, it's not even a lifelong thing like, I collect this and now I have 10,000 of them. I go through phases.
Gotcha.
Now I'm acquiring multiple of these. Now I'm acquiring multiple of these. And,
I know we don't have time for you to ask this question, but what are you collecting now?
You know what's interesting? I'm aging out. It feels like I'm aging out of this psychopathology.
Okay.
So currently, the only thing I guess you could say that I'm collecting, but this to me is gym wear. Short,
oh yeah.
And we're talking Target, Walmart, right. not fancy ass stuff.
Right.
But that's more because you use those all the time, and they do wear out, and you do need to have multiple. So I am aging out of the problem.
Okay.
I wonder if other people are like me or like you. I can't tell. Somebody's like, what a freak that Wayne is. Oh, my God. Or if they're like, oh, yeah, he's just like me. All right, let's get a news update from Chris Little, and then we will start properly handle on the news here. It's KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app. LA County has reported an additional 25 COVID-related deaths. The number of people in the hospital also went up in the county to 1,251. The big New Year's Eve party in Las Vegas is a big G-O. Go! The city says it has no plans to cancel or scale back anything. We'll take a look at your drive with BKFI in the sky next. When was the last time you had your house checked for termites? Yeah, exactly. One call to Pacific Coast Termites will get you a free home inspection. And even if you don't think you have termites, it's worth the phone call to make sure that you do have termites. Easy to treat. They do it without tenting. You can even be home when they do their job. And listen, me tell you, I've tented before. It's a nightmare. Or they'll tell you you don't have termites, which is great news. Mention KFI, get 10% off termite treatment, a two-year guarantee on their work. And I have been a customer of Pacific Coast Termite for probably 10 years or more. Call 800-PACIFIC, 800-PACIFIC, visit PacificCoastTermite.com. That's PacificCoastTermite.com.
Pacific Coast Termite, kill termites.
The clean, friendly way.
Looking to save money this year? Look at Allstate. You can get the protection you need at the low rate you want. With Allstate, you can lower your rate, not your expectations. Visit Allstate.com or call an agent for a quote today.
Rain today, highs in the mid-50s to around 60. This report brought to you by Allstate. Let's check the drive on the 5.
Boy, you bet the rain and snow. Now listen up, snowfall has flooded the section of the I-5. In both directions of the I-5 now, in between a Gorman School Road and the 1.6. Boy, it's a big section. I think we don't have enough trouble getting trucks around right now. Also, the 210 now, we just cleared a westbound problem going towards the 118, but now eastbound near the 2 freeway, a crash in lanes, getting real slow coming down from Ocean View. Be careful going to LX, coming out from Long Beach, north 405 to Wilmington before the 110, a crash there as you saw. But after that, well, a fairly good drive to the airport. Boy, it's a tough one. Don't go away. KFI in the sky. Hope to get you there faster. I'm Jeff Paul.
This report is sponsored by Discover. Real credit card questions require real people. Someone who understands your issues and works to resolve them with you. That's why Discover offers helpful U.S.-based representatives. Available 24/7. Discover. Exceptionally common sense.
Wealth isn't simply about money. It's more than just the numbers in your portfolio or your bank account. Wealth is all the everyday things that money enables you to do. The goals you're after. Things you want to accomplish. And the life you want to lead. So how do you get there? Starting the weekend of January 1st, listen to Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chapman, presented by Edelman Financial Engines. Each week, award-winning journalist Soledad O'Brien and personal finance expert Gene Chapman will explore how our financial decisions shape our everyday lives. They'll be joined by Edelman Financial Engines wealth planners and other guests to demystify challenges like tax-efficient investing, retirement planning, and more. They'll share knowledge and tools to manage your finances today and build wealth for tomorrow. Join the conversation. Everyday Wealth airs each weekend and will be available on major podcast platforms. For airtime, visit everydaywealth.com.
Radio advertising can connect your business with holiday shoppers wherever they go. Use iHeart Ad Builder to create an affordable custom radio ad right on your phone. Just click, listen, approve, then hear it on the radio. Create your customized ad today at iHeartAdBuilder.com.
Attention savvy investors. Looking for predictable monthly cash flow? Want to reduce uncertainty, hedge inflation, and stock market risk with double-digit targeted returns? If you want the safety and security of a real estate investment, but without the hassles of being a landlord, you've probably heard of NRIA. NRIA is an industry-leading real estate development firm in its 15th year developing strategically located, lower-risk, high-demand neighborhoods based on supply-demand imbalance. They're a great fit for safety-oriented investors who want cash flow and diversification into carefully chosen real estate. Learn more about the NRIA Real Estate Development Fund at NRIA.net or call 800-800-1414. That's 800-800-1414.
and offer of securities is underway by the NRIA Private Placement Memorandum. Read it first. Past performance does not guarantee future results. NRIA is a real estate development firm. Learn more at NRIA.net.
Attention thrifters, those awesome finds you get at Goodwill are even awesomer than you realize. Because as a nonprofit, Goodwill uses your purchases to fund job training and more in our neighborhood. Learn more at Goodwill.org. Sponsored by the Ad Council. If you're tired of big cable bills, you can get Newsmax TV for free. Millions are watching Newsmax. Available now on major cable systems or for free on smart TVs like Samsung, LG, and Vizio. Find it streaming on Roku, Sumo, Pluto, Amazon Fire, TiVo, Apple TV, and more. 7 million Americans have downloaded the free Newsmax app on their smartphones. It takes just seconds. Then watch us anytime, anywhere. Forbes calls Newsmax a news powerhouse. Find out why. Start watching today.
Owen Patterson and Owen has stopped and served and represented Angelenos for over four decades, settled over 15,000 cases, and $1 billion recovered for accident victims. There is only one law firm to help and protect you. If you've been injured in a car accident, become a victim of drug, elder, or sexual abuse, animal attack, or wrongfully terminated from your job, it's Owen Patterson and Owen. Free consultation with LA's award-winning law firm.
888-OPO-WINS. 888-OPO-WINS.
If holiday music turns your joy all the way up to 10, then SiriusXM is your home for the holidays. From traditional and country to pop, soul, and so much more, SiriusXM has exclusive holiday channels dedicated to the music that makes your season bright. Listen in the car on the way to the party, or in the living room as you're wrapping presents. Visit SiriusXM.com/listenholiday for how to start listening.
As 2021 comes to a close, get ready to celebrate the year in music.
We came here to have a good time.
On our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Where the iHeartRadio app comes alive.
Coming back to Fox March 22nd.
Oh, man.
Live from Los Angeles.
iHeartRadio does the Music Awards a little bit different.
Are you guys ready? Where your favorite artists will go home winners.
iHeartRadio Music Awards. Thank you.
Our 2022 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Hey, it's Steve Gregory. John and Ken have been kind enough to let me play an encore presentation of Unsolved. This Friday, we'll replay our very first episode that we call Father and Son Time. It's the story of two men who murdered three people over a four-year period. We'll also learn how the father actually drove the son to at least two of the murder scenes. That's this Friday afternoon on the John and Ken Show.
Unsolved with Steve Gregory
on KFI. Bill Handel Show. He is back from vacation on Monday. I'm here with Chris Little in for Jennifer Jones Lee. She's back on Tuesday, and it is time to officially start today's Handle on the News. Oh, you know what the lead story is. 2021 is going to go out very wet. And wet. Excuse me? And wet. Yes, more rain, more snow at the upper elevations, chilly temperatures. I think we already have 5 inches of rain in December, and it'll be way more than that after today, because today is the hardest rain that I have experienced during this series of storms. Yep, and there's a potential for debris flow in the fire areas, or some like to call the burn scars. Yeah, are they going to renew those evacuation orders, the mandatory evacuation orders for Silverado and Williams and Majesca Canyon in the bonfire burn area? Probably they should. I can tell you this, just around here now, please be careful. If you are on the roads right now, please be extra careful. There's stuff in the roads that's not supposed to be there.
Oh, I didn't see any stuff. You mean like water? Or you mean like
hazard on? There's standing water in areas where you're not used to it. And also, I saw rocks that came down from a hillside and garbage that obviously has been carried from the gutters where it normally resides into certain roadways. It's not just because it's raining and the roads are wet. There's also hazards out there.
Okay.
Ghislaine Maxwell was convicted yesterday of luring teenage girls to be sexually abused by Jeffrey Epstein. It was a trial that was supposed to be twice as long, I guess you could say, as it actually was. And Maxwell never took the stand because she maintained that she was innocent.
And also because she would have been destroyed on cross-examination. Guilty on 5 of the 6 counts. This was a jury that was very meticulous.
Yeah.
Every count, every element, what is the evidence? They asked for a lot of evidence to be represented or to go through transcripts. And you know that they were meticulous about it when you get a result like this. 5 of 6, meaning, and I think it was the enticement count, they said there's not enough evidence to convict her specifically of that, given what the law requires. Doesn't really matter in a practical sense in terms of what's going to happen to her, though.
Well, she's looking at some decades in prison.
Yeah, although at 7 o'clock, we'll go through what is more likely to be a result for
her. That's always more interesting than the case itself.
The statutory maximums that are reported all the time, rarely does anybody get that stuff. And so it's not, it's like when you talk about how many new coronavirus cases there are, that by itself isn't really helpful in any practical way.
Yep.
Doesn't reflect necessarily the reality of how bad the situation is.
Right.
And it's kind of the same thing when they go, oh, someone faces 800 years in prison. Well, technically they are facing it, but whether they get it is another thing. It's like I'm facing a used car lot of 5,000 cars. I only walk away with one, maybe even zero.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, see? Good analogy.
Yeah.
Well, several sources have revealed the name of the Los Angeles police officer who fired the shots that killed the 14-year-old innocent girl in the sitting room at the Burlington store in North Hollywood. And I don't know how I feel. You're the news guy. I prefer not to say the person's name.
Well, the reason we say it is because people have a right to know it. And it is uncomfortable for us to do that. But it's also incumbent upon us to be fully transparent, because we do give these police officers, we say to them, it's okay if you kill us. We're going to give you a gun. You can shoot me if I'm bad.
All right, well, why don't you then?
William Jones.
All right.
Junior. Now, the reason we do it is because it's already out there, and if we don't do it, we're sort of censoring the information of the KFI listener, that the KFI listener can get, and they can get it elsewhere. Now, there have been times when the media has gotten together and said, hey, look, let's not reveal this person's name or what have you. And if it gets out in the press, then, you know, maybe we will reveal it. But it comes down to wanting to be the person who has the news first. And that's not us. We're very careful with what we do before we put it out there.
Very,
I don't know if that makes sense.
No, absolutely. Absolutely. But still, the pressure exists. Yeah,
so
you have to resist sometimes the pressure to be irresponsible,
right,
if you will, which I know KFI does not, news department does not succumb to that.
No.
On this side of the microphone, you know, host, oh,
and that's the beauty of a station like this, because we are full of facts in the newsroom. You guys are full of facts, you know, in programming, but you also are full of opinions.
Yes, hot takes. Bluster,
yes,
all of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Speaking of news, let's get a news update from Chris Little, and then we'll continue Handle on the News. This is KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Memorial Hospital of Gardena is being criticized after photos have surfaced of what appear to be mistreated bodies. The photos appear to show bodies lying outside and lying on the floor in a storage facility. Vidal Herrera, who owns an autopsy company, says it doesn't appear the bodies are wrapped properly.
The problem with that is the personnel that are handling the bodies, I don't know if they were wearing protective gear, shoe covers, aprons, masks, stuff like that, because they're exposed to these pathogens.
Herrera says a funeral home recently reached out to him after seeing bodies at the hospital stacked up 7 high. Blake Trolley, KFI News. And you heard us talking about it earlier. Ghislaine Maxwell has been found guilty of sex trafficking and conspiracy charges by a jury in New York.
Maxwell, who once ran in the circle of presidents and princes, led out of the courtroom Wednesday by two U.S. marshals, now waking up behind bars, facing up to 65 years in prison.
ABC's Ariel Reshef says prosecutors called her Epstein's partner in crime for helping the disgraced financier abuse underage girls for years. News brought to you by Cunning Dental Group. A man is offering a $10,000 reward for his French bulldog taken during a walk in West Hollywood. He says the guy jumped out of a car, hit him on the head, and then grabbed the dog.
He pushed me out and slammed the door, and they sped away and dragged me with them almost 200 feet.
Police don't have a great description of the guy and of the woman in the car. All they can say now is they're looking for a man and a woman. Las Vegas will not scale back its plans for New Year's Eve gatherings. More than 300,000 people are expected to show up for events that include a New Year's Eve fireworks show on the Vegas Strip. That show was canceled last year because of the COVID-19 pandemic. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy. Let's go to Jeff Vaughn and check on the 405.
Boy, nothing easy driving here this morning. No offense, 405 now. Long Beach up to LAX. It's kind of okay to the 710, but it's getting real slow. There's a problem in Wilmington. That's kind of going away. North of the 110, it's kind of slow, but at least moving with all lanes open. Parcel lane, you really got to watch it. A lot of water coming over the center divider, so be careful. Blocking the other, the eastbound 210, a serious problem here at the 2 freeway. Crashing lanes also closing down one of the transitions to the southbound 2. I'll follow up on that for you. And this is a big one, I-5, it's closed down due to snowfall in both directions in between Gorman School Road and the 126. A busy morning. KFI in the sky, helps get you there faster. I'm Jeff Paul.
If you own a business and manage to keep 5 or more people on the payroll through the pandemic, there's a new government program that will pay you tens of thousands of dollars per employee. And this is not a loan. This is a grant. The challenge is getting your hands on this money. This is a bureaucracy. InnovationRefunds.com cuts through the red tape, helps you get the cash. They do all of the legwork. They don't charge a penny until you receive the money. And what they do is simply share a percentage of the money. They got my business a 6-figure refund. Now, their average client gets $250,000. That's impressive. Go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on the Qualify Me button, answer a few questions. InnovationRefunds.com. It's no risk, and it certainly is high reward. InnovationRefunds.com. They help me. I'm sure they can help you. InnovationRefunds.com. Rain today, highs in the mid-50s to around 60, slightly cooler in the valleys and the Inland Empire. We lead local, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Chris Little.
Gale Air Conditioning, contractor license number 1047-781. This is Ken Goodrich of Gale Air Conditioning and Plumbing. You've already heard the story of how my dad asked me to hold the flashlight for him at night while he worked on air conditioners. Dad knew he was dying, but I didn't. You know the story. Anyway, one of the things Dad would have me do is replace I still do that today, and so do all my guys. With motors rolling and compressors and electrical contacts to do an air thing, those non-stop vibrations caused by missing screws will cause your system to die long before its time. That's why we tied your unit down to factory fresh condition on every Thursday. My guys are professionals. No freak drivers at home. And don't forget our awesome duct tester. Get it. G-O-E-T-T-L. It'll keep you cool, but it's hard to spell. Call it. Get to the Ford year-end sale today. For holiday deals, you won't want to miss.
What were you saying?
Families for bringing the new year with a new Ford. Those 18 and over who are not vaccinated may be able to
available medication to prevent COVID-19.
Prescription Ricky.
To learn more, visit COVID-19.
There, that's Ultimate Package. Let's try some volume for a bit. Let's see what it is.
From Stater Brothers, fresh boneless flat meat is just $6.99 a pound. And celebrate with 36 packs of Budweiser and Bud Light, or 24 packs of Michelob Ultra for only $19.99. Here's to a happy new year from Stater Brothers Market.
At In-N-Out, our hamburgers are made with the highest quality ingredients, made fresh and by hand, made with a smile, and made to order just for you.
So,
before you purchase your new automobile this holiday season. For official rules,